Hello everyone, thank you again for tuning in to No Sweat English. My name is Carol Wright, I'll be your teacher for the day. Today I want to address a very popular topic that many ESL students want to know, is how to really know a vocabulary, right? So I want to talk a little bit about that before we talk about the board, but before we do that, please hit subscribe button and the bell if you haven't, so that let's get started now. Well, when we talk about knowing a vocabulary, from my teaching experience, many students tend to study vocabulary this way. Maybe you do the same. You take a piece of paper, you write down the English word, and then you write down the meaning in your native language. It could be Arabic, Chinese, Japanese, Korean, and the student just sits there and memorizes the whole list. Is that what you do? If that is what you do, I would like to challenge you to do something different, because this way that I'm introducing is a much more effective way to actually learn a vocabulary. Now, second thing that I want to talk about is a misconception. Misconception meaning kind of like a mistake in thinking, where students feel like, oh, to learn English, I want to memorize 500 vocabulary words a week. Now, when it comes to learning vocabulary and not memorizing them, because when we memorize something versus knowing something, when we memorize, we could forget because it's a memory. But once you actually know something, rarely do you actually forget. So I want to talk about setting a realistic goal when you are studying vocabulary. It's not always the more the better, because what would happen if you're memorizing hundreds of vocabulary a week? You forget very quickly, right? How do we avoid that? So there is a difference between learning something, learning a lot, but knowing very little bit about it, or learning little bit, but knowing a lot about something. So what I'm trying to say is set a goal that is real. Instead of saying, I want to memorize 500 vocabulary words a week, I think 25 vocabulary words a week is plenty. So that breaks down, if you're only studying on the weekdays, that breaks down about to 5 vocabulary words a day. Now you might say, teacher, that's too slow. Well, if you really want to know a vocabulary, that's my advice. If you want to memorize for some test and you don't care if you forget, then keep doing what you're doing, memorizing everything. But my job as an English teacher is not to help you memorize things, but I really want you to learn and know something. Okay, so today I'm going to introduce you a way of keeping a journal or a log of your vocabulary words and what type of information qualifies as actually knowing a word. So what does it mean to really know a word? Many students tell me, oh, I know the meaning in my language. I know the word. That's not exactly true. When you know vocabulary words, it means you know all 7 levels. Because again, my goal is to help you learn deeper into vocabulary words, not just to memorize them, okay? So if you want to memorize vocabulary words, this is not the right video for you. I'm here to teach you how to really learn a vocabulary word. So let's get started here. So when we learn a vocabulary word, my suggestion is in your notebook to separate, make a chart and separate into 7 sections. Because to know all 7 things about one word is to actually really know a word. So first thing, what it means to actually learn a word is to know the spelling. Sometimes students forget they need to know how to spell it, or they're going to spell it incorrectly in their writing. So that's not very useful for you. So first you want to know is the spelling of a word. Today I'm using the example word pleasure or pleasurable. In this case, pleasure. And you need to know how to spell it, P-L-E-A-S-U-E-R. Okay, so you should be able to flip over your notebook and be able to spell the word. Okay, so that's the first level of learning of really knowing a vocabulary word. Second, of course, is to know the meaning or the definition. So here, pleasure means the feeling of joy, happiness, and satisfaction. Okay, now students often ask, is it okay if I use my native language? Absolutely. If you feel more confident by putting your native language down, go ahead and do that. Here, my native language is Chinese, luo cui. So this is something that I put down to help me learn the word. and it's okay as long as you also have the English. Because the sooner you can learn English to English instead of just English to native language, the better off you'll be. The more vocabulary words and the deeper the knowledge of the words you're gonna get. Okay, so is it okay to add your native language? Absolutely, but make sure you also have the English. Now, of course, depending on your level, if you get to the word that you put down the meaning, you still go, I still don't understand it, then what should you do? Then maybe one of these words will become your second vocabulary words. See how you're growing in learning vocabulary words? You do that by finding meaning in everything. Okay, so feelings of joy, happiness, satisfaction. If there are any words in the meaning you don't know, make another log for it. Okay, and this is how you start growing your vocabulary words naturally. Because sometimes students say, I don't know what words to learn. Well, if you do it this way, you will naturally find words to learn because you're going to learn new words, I promise you, as we go down the list. And you can grow your vocabulary that way by making more logs for that. So, okay, we have the meaning. That's the second level. Now let's go to the third level. Do I know all the word forms for this vocabulary words? Now, as you know, in some language, there are maybe not a lot of word forms for vocabulary, but in English, we know there are nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs, and many other types of word forms. So the most common type I just listed, noun, verb, adjective, adverb, we should know the word family for the vocabulary word that you're trying to learn. So here I have pleasure, the original word. I found out from a dictionary is both a noun and a verb. So now I know when I write a sentence, I'll be able to use that to write as a noun or verb, where to put it in the sentence. There's also an adjective version of this word, which is pleasurable. Adjective, oh, now you know. And pleasureless, without pleasure. Okay, that's the adjective of it. So I know, well, the common word forms for pleasure are these three. Okay, I'm sure there are more, but I'm just using the most common ones here from the dictionary. Okay, now that I know what word forms, now I know how to form my sentences later. Okay, now the next level of learning the vocabulary word is to know the pronunciation. How do we say it? So you might want to write it down for yourself. And the accent is going to be on the first stress. It's going to be on the first syllable, pleasure. Okay, pleasure. So now I know how to say it as well. Okay, let's go deeper. Let's write a sample sentence. Am I able to do that? I take pleasure in playing golf. Okay, that means I find a lot of happiness or joy and satisfaction in playing golf. Okay, so you're expressing that pleasure. So now I have subject, verb, object. I'm using pleasure as a noun. I encourage you, this is just an example lesson, but I encourage you to try to write more sentences using the different word forms that will even make your English better. Now, when we talk about pleasure, in the dictionary, it showed me the verbs to use with the noun pleasure is to take pleasure, give pleasure, or to have pleasure. So now I know how to use it. Okay, so that's very, very important when you are studying vocabulary. Now let's go another level deeper. We're gonna talk about the synonyms of the word pleasure. Now synonyms means words that have similar meaning. Now again, this is a perfect way to grow my vocabulary. So what's another way I can say pleasure? I looked in the dictionary, it says delight or indulgence. Now you might say, teacher, I don't know these words. Great, now take these words and make another log for yourself. Now you're truly learning vocabulary very naturally, okay? Because you're building on the words you already know and the relationship that you understand between the words. So next time you see the word indulgence, you might think of the word pleasure or vice versa, okay? Now another way to also grow your vocabulary is also know the antonym. Antonym means words with opposite meaning. So I'm learning even more words. So what's an antonym of pleasure? The dictionary tells me it's pain. Oh, that doesn't sound very good. Or displeasure. Okay, now I learn a new word. All right. So I just wanted to show you when you're making a vocabulary log, this is what I encourage you to do. Now I know this looks like a lot of time and a lot of work, but I promise you if you do this, you will really know the word pleasure. Okay, so again, it's about getting a deeper knowledge of vocabulary words instead of, I know 500 words for 2 minutes, but then I forget the next day. So this is about really knowing a word, really putting yourself into learning the vocabulary word, is to know all seven levels of that, okay? Now, hopefully you won't go back to the way of memorizing vocabulary, just English word and Arabic or Chinese or Korean and Japanese and just memorize that way, because you will forget. My job is really help you to know a vocabulary word. So I really hope you find this helpful. So in my description, you'll be able to find a worksheet that I created for you that has this typed up for you as an example, so that you can continue using that piece of paper to help you record vocabulary words of your own. All right? Thank you again for tuning in. Hopefully I've been helpful in helping you learn vocabulary. I'll see you next time. Again, don't forget to subscribe. You have a great day. Thank you. Bye-bye.